Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Today, the 17th Sunday in the ordinary time cycle B, I greet all of you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today's reading could help us to reflect so many topics, but I take only a very simple topic. Give, and you will be given. Give out, you will get it back. To put it in the words of Jesus, it will be like this: give and gifts will be given to you, a good measure, packed together, shaken down, and overflowing, it will be poured into your lap. Luke chapter 6, 38. Today, first reading, we have a very simple incident in the life of Elisha the prophet. A man from Baal Shalisha brought some fruit, some bread from the first fruits of the harvest. And when Elisha saw this, he would give to the people. When the servant objected it, it will not be enough for the people. People are too many. The food is only a small quantity. The servant may have his own hidden agendas to object it. But still, the prophet insisted that it should be given to the people. And he gave and gave and gave out. And he got it, and it was God finished. It was not God finished. It was given to the people. It was given to the people, and it was given to, they were giving to the people. He gave and gave and gave. All had their fill. Elisha was sure it will be given to him back. He gave out. But he got gifts back in good measure, packed down, shaken down, and overflowing, was poured into his lap. Sharing is a basic Christian command. It is a demand of the Christian spirituality. We share with other people. We are Catholics taking part in the Eucharist. What do we do in the Eucharist? There we take the bread and say, this is the body of Jesus broken for the people. We take wine and say, this is the blood of Jesus poured out for the people. Broken for the people, poured out for the people. And then Jesus told, do this in memory of me. We understand it as a ritualistic practice, and we do it in the celebration of the Mass. But actually, Jesus is asking us, do this sharing as I shared with you. You share it. Whenever we share something with other people, I will say we are celebrating the Eucharist. We are applying the command of Jesus, do this in memory of me. Whenever we give something to the people, we are giving to the people, and we are sharing to other people. The early Christians were practicing this. You read it. The believers were of one heart and mind, and no one claimed that any of his possessions was his own, but they had everything in common, and there was no needy person in their community. We share not only our money, we share not only our material things, we share whatever we have. We share our time with the people. It is not only material things, money or other food or anything like that. It is our time we share with other people. Sitting with elderly people. Go and visit people who are sick. They are spending some time with them. Let us hear them, their stories. They have to tell something. Their struggles, their difficulties, their inner pains, they want to share with us. Let us be patient enough to share with them. Our time with them. Show our mobile phones we have, and we have new items or interesting things, very funny things. Show them also, let them also enjoy. sharing our time with the people. Another form of sharing is spiritual. We pray for other people. Intercessory prayer. When we do the intercessory prayer, we exercise our priestly authority. We pray for other people. We send to them our positive energy. There is a spiritual energy within us. We are sharing that spiritual energy. We are sending positive waves to other people. You may ask me sometimes how a person far miles and miles and miles away how it will be effective, how my prayer will be effective upon that person. We must know that by prayer we get connected with all source of power, the power of God, and God will direct all of our powers to the person needed. So it is a positive energy we are sending to other person through prayer. We are sharing our prayer. Fourthly, we share our sufferings. We suffer for other people. Sometimes we have to bear certain things. In silence we have to suffer certain things. We suffer certain things for the sake of other people. In our bodily pains and suffering, we pray for other people. And our power of suffering will be effective in other person, which will be bringing healing to other people. We see Jesus told, power has gone out of me. The power of God is residing within us. We extend our hands, we extend our mouth, we extend our person to other people by sharing. We share our spiritual resources. And the power of Jesus was so vital and vitalizing other people, and they were revived, they were healed by the power. In a short way, in a small way, our power also residing within us, and we also share the same thing with other people. Let us pray that we may get the spirit of sharing. We have the good example of Elisha. We have the good example of the small boy who he gave everything, whatever he had, to the hands of the apostles. And we have the good example of Jesus. Let us share what we have. May God bless all of us. Amen.